JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for January the 5th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Head of Research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other major currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained against the yen and the euro, while it lost ground versus the pound, the Swiss franc, and the Aussie. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the kiwi and the Canadian dollar. Now, the weakening of the yen combined with the strengthening of the pound and the Aussie suggests that markets may have traded in a risk-on manner yesterday and today in Asia. That said, the strengthening of the franc points otherwise. Thus, in order to clear things up, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. European stocks extended their New Year rally, perhaps as participants continue to cheer evidence that the Omicron coronavirus variant may be less severe than initially feared, despite cases around the globe surging to new records. That said, sentiment softened during the US session, with only Dow closing in positive waters. The S&P finished the session virtually unchanged, while Nasdaq tumbled 1.33%. Asian indices continued in a declining mode as well. Now, maybe sentiment turned around after the ISM manufacturing index for December slid by more than expected, or it may have been remarks by Minneapolis Fed President Neel, who said yesterday that he expects that the Fed will need to raise interest rates twice this year. Yes, two hikes are less than the three indicated by the latest dot plot, but taking into account that Kashkari has been one of the most dovish members, supporting the view that interest rates will need to stay at zero until at least 2024, this is a strong hawkish switch by him. If Kashkari now sees two hikes this year, some other more hawkish members may be in favor of four or more. Now, as for our view, we prefer to adopt a more cautious stance with regards to US equities, as rising expectations over faster hikes by the Fed may result in further retreat. Remember that higher interest rates mean higher borrowing costs for firms, but also lower present values for high growth companies like tech firms, as those are usually valued by discounting expected future earnings. Yes, lately we've been noting that investors may have already digested the idea of higher interest rates this year, but anything pointing to a faster rate path than already digested is possible to affect their decisions. With that in mind, we prefer to be more optimistic on European indices for now, as the ECB is on the dovish spectrum of the map of the major central banks. Now, moving to the energy market, yesterday we had an OPEC Plus meeting with the group agreeing to stick to its planned increase in output for February, as it expects Omicron to have a short-lived impact on demand. Oil prices traded slightly higher, but not much, perhaps because this was the anticipated outcome. The Canadian dollar was found virtually unchanged. Was found virtually unchanged against its US counterpart this morning, also reflecting that the outcome was investors' base case scenario. However, bearing in mind that we do expect oil prices to continue trending north and the Bank of Canada to proceed with tightening its policy this year, we do see the case for the loonie to stay supported, at least for now. Now, as for the rest of today's events, we have the final services and composite market PMIs for December from the Eurozone and the US, which are expected to confirm their initial forecasts. The US ADP report for the month is also due to be released, with the forecast suggesting that the private sector has gained 413,000 jobs from 534,000 in November. However, as we noted several times in the past, we prefer to refrain from using this figure as a gauge of the NFP number, as recent history has shown that it is not very reliable. Now, later in the day, we get the minutes from the latest FOMC meeting when officials dropped the transitory wording with regards to inflation from their statement and doubled the pace of their quantitative easing tapering process, which means that conditional upon maintaining that pace for the months to come, the process will end in March. Most importantly, though, the new dot plot pointed to 3/4 point rate increases in 2022 and 3 more for 2023 at a time when the financial community was fully pricing in only 2 liftoffs for this year. Now, given that this was one of the bigger meetings with a new dot plot and updated economic projections, we don't expect the minutes to reveal any new important information. We believe that dollar traders will stay more focused on the US employment report for December, due out on Friday. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.